poop. Hammer missing too. Poof. I just thought your boo now. Ooh, she gon' eat the poop. Bread up in that guy, and you would think that bag would come and walk. Smile up in my face, but like a plastic bag, I see through you.
Take it. Take it.
Gentlemen, stay social with your favorite conference. Search MEAC Sports on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and on YouTube for day-to-day updates on everything MEAC. Also use the hashtags IBackToMEAC and MEAC Nation to see your posts reposted. And when playoff football is on, you have to be at B-Dubs for our $5 game day deals. Buffalo Wild Wings, Arundel Mills, Owings Mills, White Marsh, Wings, Beer, Sports. From the moment you enter the newly renovated Holiday Inn Baltimore Inner Harbor until you return home, you experience all the charms that give our hometown its Charm City moniker. The Harbor, the Baltimore Inner Harbor is conveniently located 3 blocks from the Baltimore Inner Harbor attractions and is across from the Baltimore Convention Center. And within 1 mile, guests can find the Horseshoe Casino, Hard Rock Cafe, and M&T Bank Stadium, home of your playoff-bound Baltimore Ravens. The Holiday Inn Baltimore Inner Harbor. THB Bagels and Deli in Charles Village is a proud sponsor of Coppin State Basketball. Come and enjoy Baltimore's hometown bagels made fresh daily. And don't forget, Coppin State Athletics starts a new tradition this season with the singing of our alma mater at the end of each game. So we ask at that time, you please stand and join us in honoring Coppin State with the singing of our alma mater immediately following today's contest. Thank you. Oh, one other note, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you, please keep your feet off the seat in front of you. Please do not put your feet on the seat in front of you. Thank you.
She's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. I did have a 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light, ay, like a light, ay, like a light, ay. Slept through the flight, ay, not for the night, ay. 767, man, this shit got double bedroom, man. I still got scores to settle, man. I crept down a block, made a right, yeah. Cut the lights, yeah. Pay the price, yeah. Think it's sweet, no, it's on sight, yeah. Nothing nice, yeah. Vegas in my eyes, Jesus Christ, yeah. Checks over stripes, yeah. That's what I like, yeah. That's what we like, yeah. Lost my respect, yeah. You not a threat. When I shoot my shot, that shit wetty like on Shaq. See the shots that I took, wet like on Book, wet like on Lizzie. I be spinning valley circle blocks till I'm busy. Like, where is he? No one seen him. I'm trying to clean him, yeah. She's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Now I hit the FBO with duffels in my hands. Woo. I did half a 13 hours till I land. Had me out like a light,
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 like a light.
Yeah, pass the dogs and Sully, sending texts, ain't sending kites. Yeah, he said keep that on rock, I say you know this in my spice. Yeah, it's absolute, it's absolute, it's absolute.
In New York, I'm in Lil Rock, hiding in my socks. Running from a op, and I threw that up. What? And I'm on the block.
What?
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 And I'm on the block.
What?
In New York, I'm in Lil Rock. Hiding in my sock.
What?
Hiding in my sock.
What?
Selling every rock.
What? What?
What?
Ladies and gentlemen, the NCAA, the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, Coppin State University, and Savannah State University encourage and promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, ethnic, or sexual comments or other intimidating actions will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the physical education complex. Also, consumption or possession of alcoholic beverages is strictly prohibited. We thank you in advance for your cooperation.
Like a pinata, few blue Balenciagas, Robin Jean with the phone pots, hit the claw and I'm a black bottles. With me, whoop, 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 no set tripping, ain't no fool. G's a piece of 10K gold, I'm a fool, you better act cool. German Shepherds in my backyard, train to kill, I was born to deal. I was on the hill, RIP till one, the rest in peace, cool for deal. My daddy back out, you don't f*** the door, hit the magic city, pack it out. You hang on me, I don't give a f*** on the street, you can walk it out. I'm in Pittsburgh with a lot of young with a bankroll. Scrape the pot, I was in the hood. My mama stayed on Glenwood. 17 with a 38. Don't f*** around and make me 38. 24 hours out trying to get it. I been waiting on first 48.
Ladies and gentlemen, this time we ask that you all please rise as we honor America and our troops, servicemen and women across the country. We ask you please rise for the playing of our national anthem. Once again, we say good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Coppin State University and the Physical Education Complex. Happy New Year to you all. Today's game is the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference Contest between the Savannah State University Tigers and your Coppin State University Eagles. And now, here are your starting lineups. First for the visiting Tigers of Savannah State University. At forward, 6'7" and a junior from Sanford, Florida, 00 Terrell Harper. At the other forward, 6'8" and a junior from St. Croix in the United States Virgin Islands, number 5, Romani Hansen. At guard, 6'1" and a senior from Statesboro, Georgia, number 1, Zaquavian Smith. At guard, 6'1" and a junior from Shiraw, South Carolina, number 3, Zach Sellers. And at guard, 6'4 and a junior from Philadelphia, Mississippi, number 11, Jaquan Dotson. Savannah State assistant coaches are Clyde Wormley, Timothy Hardley, and Joseph Flagler. The head coach of Savannah State University Tigers is Horace Broadnax.
Personal goals, this is the one for real. We work hard every day. Everything just coming together. So I got faith in this. Like, I'm confident that we're going to have a great year this year.
We got a lot again. That's something you can't lag on.
I'm excited because of our effort. Just keep competing.
Personal goals.
Yeah. Champions of the United States.
We finally made it out of them trippy together.
Santa Claus. Got 3 boys out that Molly ripping panties off. Flying private to Dubai, we up them Zanny bars. Oh, scary, I was turning cameras off, please.
Oh, yeah. Hey, one time on 3, family on 6. One, two, three,
one time.
4, 5, 6,
10.
And now, the starting lineup for your Coppin State University Eagles. At forward, 6'7 and a senior from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, number 1, Chad Andrews Fulton. At the other forward, 6'8 and a senior from Kennesaw, Georgia, number 5, Cedric Council Jr. At guard, 6'4 and a sophomore from Newport News, Virginia, number 2, Taquan Drummond. At guard, 6'2 and a sophomore from Bowie, Maryland, number 13, DeJuan Clayton. And at guard, 6'6 and a senior from Wellingboro, New Jersey, number 22, Lamar Morgan. Eagle Director of Basketball Operations is Joseph Gripper. Assistant Coach is Charles Agamagu. Associate Head Coach is John Auslander. And the Head Coach of your Eagles is Juan Pixa.
Courtside at the PEC at Coppin State University. That, ladies and gentlemen, was the voice of Gary Williams. The voice of the PEC here at Coppin State. For the Tigers, 3-11 on the year under Horace Broadnax, coming off a loss to Iowa, 110-64. And you heard the starters for the Tigers, Smith, Sellers, Harper, Hanson, and Dotson. For Coppin, trying to snap a streak. They started non-conference 0-15. Both teams, well, they're getting ready to tip off the MEAC season. Juan Dixon in his second year at the helm here at Coppin State, coming off a loss to Notre Dame, put a scare in the Fighting Irish. 63-56. They'll deploy Clayton, Drummond, Morgan, Andrews, Fulton, and Council. Happy New Year on the Coppin State Sports Network. By the way, a note to pass along from the women's game. Brooke Fields, 10 for 10 at the line. That's the best performance at the free throw line. 10 or more free throws in a game without a miss in school history. Congratulations to Brooke Fields, even though the ladies fell to Savannah State 76-70. Shedden Hanson in the jump circle to get us going. Coppin in the white uniforms, Savannah State in the blue uniforms. Tip controlled emphatically by Coppin State. Clayton on the march. Now to Andrews Fulton, head of the key. Hands it up to Drummond. Top side of the right to Morgan. Kicks it out to Council. Council curls back to the head of the key. Now for Drummond. Taquan on the take. Far side of the right. Give it up to Andrews Fulton out of the corner. Chad swings the top side left. Now to Clayton around the Chad Andrews Fulton screen to the right side. 12 to shoot. Council out of the right corner. Dribbles in the lane, floats it up, glass rim, no good. Tip free by Council. Off his knee, they'll battle for it along the sideline, picked up by Sellers. Sellers on the run out, skips it. In between the rings, now to Dotson. Dotson on the catch, launches a three from the head of the key. It's on the way, good. Juan Dotson puts Savannah State on top 3-0. This is nothing new for the Tigers. They're amongst the nation's leaders in attempts and makes from three. Drummond with it, head of the key, backs it out with the right hand. Left side, line to the lane, fights it up, rim and good. 3-2, Savannah State. And an issue with the shot clock. It's starting at 35. They're going to reset that, obviously. Comes at 18:48 to go in the opening half, a 3-2 Savannah State lead. Inbounder will be Harper. At least that was the idea. Again, he heads over. They have to reset it. As a master key, if you will, to change that shot clock. And there on our replay situation, you saw Harper with the basketball ahead of the key. And immediately the game was stopped with 18:48 to go and the issue with the shot clock trying to be resolved. And now both teams will head off to their respective sidelines. And not only did the shot clock not function properly, the scoreboard has yet to post the two-point field goal for Coppin State. I've coined a phrase over the years. Technology is wonderful when it decides it wants to work. And the young lady working the shot clock apparently is having a major issue resetting it. They may have to do a hard system reboot, if you will. So in the women's game earlier, Coppin turned the ball over prolifically, and it cost them a win in conference, 76-70. They trailed 18-16 after one, by one at the break after a 19-18 second quarter. And Savannah State led by seven with a 23-17 third quarter, 59-52 going to the fourth, and a valiant effort by Coppin State to cut it to one at 68-67 goes for naught because Savannah State closed out the game on an 8-3 run, including two free throws with less than half a second to go with a late foul in the game, making that final score 76-70. So now the shot clock has moved to 20. We'll look at one of the officials right now having a conversation with the Coppin State coaching staff. Savannah State using the time as well as an extra timeout here in the early going. Next up for Savannah State, they'll go across town to Morgan State on Monday, 7:30 tip for the men. Of course, the women precede that at 5:30. Coppin heads to Delaware State on Monday night, 5:30 for the ladies, 7:30 for the guys. And then next weekend, Savannah State continues on the road. They're at Florida A&M, 2-4 on Saturday afternoon. And then for Coppin State, they'll play host to Norfolk State. Ladies at 2, men at 4, and then Monday night, the 14th, it is South Carolina State here at the PEC before a road trip to North Carolina. Take on Central on the 19th and A&T on the 21st before coming home for three consecutive home games, including January, beginning February, and then a three-game road set for Coppin State early to mid-February, and then closing out the home slate against Howard on homecoming on the 23rd of February, and then senior night against Delaware State on the 25th of February before closing it out at Norfolk State on March 2nd, and a game will bring you at Morgan State on March 7th before heading to the Scope in Norfolk March 11th through the 16th. Shot clock now stands at 30. Inbound for Savannah State on the far sideline. I'm with Coach Dixon. You got to run a couple seconds off. They're already in the forecourt. At least 29 or 28. Head of the key three is on the way. Oh, my, good again. Three ball for Romani Hansen. 6-2 Savannah State. Back-to-back threes to open the scoring. Morgan can knock down a three or two, if you will. Clayton on the run, right of the lane. Fights it up, left hand, rim. It trickles off. Got his own miss back, left wing behind the arc. Tip free by Andrews Fulton. Now to Clayton, head of the key. Top side of the right to Drummond. To Quain, backs it out with a left hand. Now to the right. Post-entry feed to Sed. On the block, turns right. Glass and good. Cedric Council. 6-4 Savannah State. Head of the key. Harper comes to a screeching halt. Feeds it far side of the right to Smith. He wants a three. Rimming off. Sed the rebound. Got tripped up. Goes to the floor. He's still down. And the takeaway by Harper. He's going to score. Makes it an 8-4 Savannah State lead. And Council is in a seated position on the floor. And with that, Justin Steers is going to check in for Coppin State. Sed's going to head off under his own power. Sed says he's all right, but he's going to come over to the Coppin State bench. Be looked at by the training staff just for a moment. I believe he'll be back in before too long. So Justin Steers, 6'6 freshman, is on the floor. And for those watching on the video stream, he has the brightest shoes on the floor. Top side left, Drummond. Now to the forecourt. Far side left corner now to Steers. Clayton with it. Near side of the right to Drummond. Right corner kick to Morgan. High right feed, Andrews Fulton. Gave it back to Morgan. Morgan nearly lost the handle. Step left, wants a three on the way. Back of the rim, no good. Long rebound out to Steers.
Move it, Jeff, move it.
Right wing at the MEAC logo. Now headed the key to Morgan. Far side left to Clayton. Took his eye off the ball and ends up in the front row. Keep it 8-4 Savannah State. 17-14 to go. In the opening half. Inbound now for Sellers. Sellers on the bounce, left of the lane, got cut off. Hands it off to a trailing Dotson. He wants a three hard off the window, no good. Andrews Fulton corrals the loose ball, looking for an outlet. Bounce it off to Clayton. That's deflected. Last touch by Harper, out of bounds. Shot clock's at 25. That means they've got half the time to get it across the time stripe. Morgan to Clayton. Along the baseline. He's got to hurry. Up the left side to Morgan. Takes a bounce. Fires it ahead to Andrews Fulton. And did they get it across? The official on the baseline said they didn't. Indeed, 10-second violation. Harper from the sideline to inbound. Your side left to Sellers. Sellers top side to the right. On the bounce, defended by Clayton. Kicks it out to the right corner, now for Smith. Lob it back to the jump circle. Sellers on the catch of the bounce. Takes it right of the lane. Swings it off the side of the glass. No good. In traffic, glass no, but a foul on the drive by Dotson. Andrews Fulton with the foul. That's his first. And out the free throw line. Puts it on the way. Front of the rim. Side of the rim and off. Keep it 8-4 Tigers. Top of the home whites. Trimmed in gold. Savannah State in the road blues. Second one's good. Dotson now with four as he split a pair. 9-4 Tigers. 3.5 minutes in. Drummond back to Clayton. Clayton on the bounce, now to the forecourt. Coming back to his left toward the head of the key. Drives toward the head of the key, gave it up to Drummond. Left side three, left of the rim and off. Rebound of the Tigers. Dotson on the run out, got to the right elbow and stopped. Swings it near side left to Harper. Harper going line to the lane, lost the handle, out of bounds. That comes at 16:07 to go. Coppin down by five, 9-4. Morgan on the inbound now for Clayton. Clayton on the march. Sends it back to Drummond. Drummond now to Clayton. Clayton between the rings. Takes it right side behind the arc. Right corner kick to Drummond. Back to Clayton. Top side left to Morgan. Gave it up left corner to Steers. Eight to shoot. Steers going to work on the side of the lane. Glass rim no good. Got his own miss back. Tried to fight it up in traffic. Thought he got fouled. And coming the other way is Harper. Harper runs strong on Chad. Glass and good. Harper's second field goal gave him four. 11-4. The Tiger advantage. Steers left in a lane. Into a triple team. Threw it away. Picked off by Hansen. Gave it up. Now for Dotson. Swings it near side left. Harper on the catch. Fadeaway three. Back of the rim. No good. Weak side rebound to Clayton. Trying to clear some traffic. Draws a double team for a moment. Now dribbles right through Hansen. Into the forecourt. Andrews Fulton. Right side Drummond. Drummond headed the key. Top side left to Clayton. Clayton with it high left on the bounce. Takes it strong off the side of the lane. Fights it up and good. DeJuan Clayton. His first field goal cuts it to 11-6 Savannah State. Right side pull up for three. Rim it off for Smith. We're going the other way on the foul on Savannah State. It's assessed on Hansen. That's his first. It brings us to the under. 16 media timeout. 14:38 to go. First half. It's now Savannah State leading Coppin State 11-6. Back after this timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. .38 to go in the opening half. It's also wild card weekend in the NFL playoffs. Indianapolis has jumped on Houston early, 14-0. Just over 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. Here it is 11-6, Savannah State with the advantage. Coppin out rebounding Savannah State, 6-3. Turnover margin, 4-1, Coppin State. So on the inbound, Clayton back to Drummond. Out of the forecourt. Clayton with it back to Drummond.
Reverse, hurry up.
17 to shoot, Drummond. Back to the jump circle now for Clayton. Now to Steers, head of the key. Back to Drummond. Gave it back to Clayton. Right of the Chad Andrews Fulton screen. Eight to shoot. Clayton turning left and got hand checked. That foul is on the newly entered Collins Joseph. Morgan inbound from the sideline. Now for Clayton, head of the key. Clayton on the bounce, top side right. Hesitation dribble, line to the lane, fights it over the left hand, back of the rim, no. Tip follow is good. Justin Steers. 11-8, Savannah State. Under 14 minutes to go, first half. Joseph's got it. The floater on the way. Back of the rim. No good. Rebound Clayton. Takes his man off the bounce. Now to the forecourt. Uses the Andrews Fulton screen. Left of the lane. Going strong to the left hand. Side of the glass. No, but a whistle and a foul. Foul is on Jalen Smith. That's his first. Comes at 13:43 to go in the opening half. Clayton puts the front end on the way, and it's good. For course, Clayton coming off the injury from a year ago. Glad to have him back in the Eagles uniform.
He's got double zero. He's got double zero. Four. Justin. Four. He's got double zero. Hey. Tell one. You got two. You have one.
Second free throw by Clayton is good. So Dewan Clayton pulls Coppin within one at 11-10. Right to left. Joseph the handle. Nearly lost it. Gave it up top side left on a Harper. Goes left in a lane. Kicks it out left corner. Three ball is on the way, rimming off out of the hand of Smith. Rebound Andrews Fulton, nearly had it poked away. Rolls it to the forecourt, finally picks it up and got taken down. Into the forecourt, and that foul is going to be assessed on John Grant Jr. Drummond checks out. Evan Williams checks in for the first time. 5'11 freshman for Coppin State. At the 13:25 mark, Coppin down by one at 11-10. Inbound to Clayton. Top side of the right to Morgan. Back to Clayton, head of the key. And off the ball, Steers got bumped off. Second one on Grant Jr. He's been in all of about a minute, maybe two, and he's picked up two quick ones. He'll check out. Jaquan Dotson checks back in. 4 points out of Philadelphia, Mississippi.
Hey, Bird, you have one. Tay, 11. In.
Morgan from the sideline with 20 to shoot. Bouncing in now for Clayton. Far side left out of Steers. Hands it off to Williams. Top side of the right to Clayton. Shovels it down. Chad Andrews Fulton goes right hand and scores. Chad's field goal gives Coppin their first lead at 12-11. Caught in midair was Joseph. Somehow found Harper. Swings it right side now to Smith and off the ball. Travel. That was going to be a moving screen.
Stay solid, Judge. Stay solid, Judge.
We'll take the turnover either way. 12:56 to go in the opening half. Now Coppin up by one at 12-11. 8-3 Coppin State run, having trailed 8-4. To 8-2 if you prefer, trailing 9-4. Andrews Fulton on the doorstep, scores the right hand again. Philly makes it 14-11. 12:35 to go in the half. Back of the rim, no, by Terrell Harper, but he's fouled the way up. So Chad just picks up his second. Here comes Ken Auslander to the scorer's table. He'll be joined by Nigel Marshall and 7-footer Brendan Medley-Bacon. Fans, I'm glad he took a seat near the scorer's table, because if he stands up, I can't see the other end of the floor. Front of the rim, no good. Harper will have another. Now the change is being made. Clayton, Morgan, and Steers coming off. Check that. Andrews Fulton coming off. Morgan will stay. Williams, Marshall, Auslander, and Medley-Bacon. Second free throw, rimming off. Marshall the rebound. Outlet now for Williams. Williams back to Marshall. Looking at a double team. Skips it down to the forecourt. Lamar on the catch of the bounce. Gave it up to a trailing Williams for a three. Rim it off. Rebound to Joseph. Quickly the other way. Harper's got it. Top side left. Takes it left to the lane. Spins back to his right. Swings it far side of the right. Three ball for Dotson. Right of the rim. No good. Rebound in traffic to Williams. Quickly up the floor, not a Marshall. Coppin's got numbers the other way. Morgan catching fire three. Rim halfway down and out. Tapped out to Joseph. Joseph on the run out. Head of the key. Hesitation dribble back to his right. Swings it back to a trailing Harper. He wants a three. Front of the rim, no good. It's off of Savannah State. Out of bounds. That brings us to the under 12 media timeout at 11:43 to go in the half. Coppin State leads Savannah State 14-11 on the Coppin State Sports Network.
Here's a video of two Coppin State students at Buffalo Wild Wings during their lunch break.
Bro, what's up? Basketball season this year is going to be lit. See, all these new players we got, bro.
Yeah.
We got Philly, New York. I think they even got somebody from Australia, bro.
What?
Australia.
I could have sworn I seen somebody that was like 8 feet.
8 foot?
Yeah.
Light skin boy to be.
Yeah.
Yo, it's going to be crazy, man. Oh, definitely shout out to the basketball team, hey, man.
Shout out to the basketball team,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, you don't go to Cobb, you ain't popping either.
Straight away.
Out to the men's basketball team. Let's go, Eagles. Eight cup, man.
/11:43 to go in the opening half. Coppin leads Savannah State 14-11. Todd Burley here at the PEC. Coppin controlling the glass right now, 12-5. And Coppin, 9 defensive rebounds, and they've kept Savannah State from getting a single offensive rebound. At the 11:43 mark of the opening half. Coppin the lead at 14-11 and the ball. Ken Oslander on the inbound. Gets it into Williams. Williams on the bounce. Hesitation dribble in the backcourt. Now to the forecourt. Directs traffic. And now swings it high right to Morgan. Now head of the key to Williams. Williams on the bounce. Gave it up to Morgan. High left. Back now for Nigel Marshall. Pulls up from the left of the lane, rimming off. Got his own miss back, ducks in with a right. Tried to fight it up, lost it again. And they say he went out of bounds. That was an odd sequence at the other end of the floor. Sellers now the handle. Tigers trail by 3. Now between the rings to Hanson. Hanson on the bounce, top side left. Dotson. Back to Hanson. 15 to shoot. Hanson wants a 3. Right of the rim, no good. Oslander will let it bounce out of bounds.
Great job, Brendan.
As it goes to that far side of the floor. CoppinStateSports.com. Everything you need to know about Coppin State Athletics. Morgan back to Williams. Williams on the bounce. Picks it up. Swings it over the top. On the catch, Oslander. Hands it back to a trailing Nigel Marshall. And now Williams backs it out. Marshall hands it off to Oslander. 13 to shoot. Head of the key to Williams. Curls right. Bounce it off to the doorstep. That was deflected. And last touch by Coppin State out of bounds. Closing in on 10.5 to go. Here in the first half. Sellers on the bounce. High left. Reversing off between the rings. Gave it up to Hanson. Right side 3 across the iron. No by Smith. And over the back, I believe, he's going to be Dotson. Indeed, that is the call. Dotson picks up his first. Hanson checks out. Grant Jr. checks back in with the 2 early fouls. Oslander on the inbound, now for Williams. Gave it up to Morgan. Morgan on the bounce, back now to Williams. Into the forecourt, right of the jump circle, 20 to shoot. Williams goes right of the Medley Bacon screen, and it's a moving screen violation on Brendan Medley Bacon. It's his first, third on Coppin's team. Morgan and Williams will check out. Clayton Drummond back in. Sellers on the catch. Gave it back to your side left. Harper wants a 3. High off the back iron. No good. Savannah State the rebound. They'll reset it. 3 ball halfway down and out for Harper. Rebound to Medley Bacon. Outlet now for Clayton. Coppin's got numbers into the forecourt. Marshall gallops to the glass, wave it off. They say he traveled. Oh, my goodness. Great take off the left of the lane. They call that a Euro step now. 9:43 to go in the opening half. Coffin by three at 14-11. Head of the key now to Harper. He traveled. That wasn't a Euro step. Joseph back in. He's going to replace Fabian Smith, 6'1 senior out of Statesboro, Georgia. Oslander on the inbound now for Drummond. Drummond gave it up left side, now to Clayton. Into the jump circle, now to the forecourt. Trying to go left of that screen, he does. Medley Bacon on the doorstep, had it blocked out of bounds. 13 to shoot. Checking in will be Smith. Senior out of Barnwell, South Carolina. Off the inbound, Drummond from the baseline. Excuse me, Clayton from the baseline to inbound. Oslander on the catch, has Drummond to his left. Right side, Clayton, eight to shoot. DeJuan head of the key with five to shoot, launches from three and buries it. Clayton with seven. And the lead is six at 17-11, Coppin State. An answer triple, rim it off out of the hand of Grant Jr. Rebound to Marshall, in traffic, in the backcourt, throws to the forecourt, Medley Bacon. Left side to Clayton, DeJuan tracks it down left corner. Hits a trailing Marshall. Back to Clayton, clean look at a three, rim it off. Rebound Joseph. Bounce it off high right. Three ball on the way by Grant Jr. High off the iron, no good. Marshall trying to win that rebound. He does, and he's fouled. Dotson with his second. Seventh on Savannah State. Sends Coppin to the line for one and the bonus. Steers and Morgan back to the scorer's table. Medley Bacon and Oslander both check out. Nigel Marshall stands in at the free throw line. First one's on the way and good. 18-11, Coppin State.
Justin, 12.
Second one's on the way, true. Marshall got them both. 19-11 Coppin. Right side three is on the way. Rim it off out of the hand of Joseph. Rebound to Lamar Morgan. Trying to step through a double team. Bounced it off down for Drummond. Now for Clayton. He got caught at half court by Harper, who gets called for the blocking foul. His first. He was trying to draw a charge. Half step early, in my opinion. So now Clayton at the free throw line. Again on the eighth team foul for Savannah State. One and the bonus. Front end is on the way. Good. DeJuan Clayton now with eight. 20-11 Coppin.
Justin!
16 unanswered by Coppin State, having once trailed 11-4. Clayton got them both. Give him nine. 21-11, Coppin by 10. 8-10 to go in the half. On the bounce, near side left. Harper going to work. Got caught in traffic. Kicks it out right side. Sellers wants a three. Rim it off. Offensive rebound. Glass and good. On the follow by Smith. 21-13. Coppin with the lead. 7:45 to go in the half. That ball is deflected out of bounds. Last touch by Savannah State. Brings us to a timeout on the floor. 7:45 to go opening half. It's now Coppin State leading Savannah State. 21-13. Back after this timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. great look on the live video stream, CommonStateSports.com. Some of the young fans taking in the game tonight here at the PEC. There you go. It is Saturday night here in the Charm City. 7:45 to go, opening half. 21-13, Coppin State. And they got that lead on a 17-0 run after trailing 11-4. Ran that lead to 10-21-11. Rebounding margin, 28, Coppin. However, they've turned it over 8 times. Savannah State, just 3. Off the inbound, now it comes to Clayton. DeJuan on the bounce, goes left to the Marshall screen. Left side, Morgan behind the arc. Now back to Clayton. 10 to shoot, it comes to Drummond right side. Now for Marshall, right of the lane. Jump stop in the lane, fights to the left hand and scores. Marshall now with 4. 23-13, Coppin. Right side answer, 3, rimming off for Harper. Rebound to Smith, kicks it out near side left. And now the refeed. Smith off the right side, back iron, no good. Drummond over the top to Steers, bounce it back for Morgan, picked off. Right idea, but Sellers read the play perfectly. Mishuroff, South Carolina product, hands it off top side left. Harper thought about the 3. Drummond gives him left baseline, then cut him off coming to his right. Now for Smith. Smith spins right on Steers. Steers got a piece of it going up. Tracks down the loose ball, far corner. Over the top for Clayton. Up the right side, Drummond explodes right of the lane, throws it up. That was blocked. Blocked by Smith. Down the floor come the Tigers. Left side kick out. Sellers wants a 3. Back of the rim, no good. Rebound to Smith. Top side of the right. Now for Joseph. Rimming off. Knocked it free. Joseph got it back. Kicks it out high right. Into the hands of Smith. Runs it in the lane. Swings it near side left. A 3 is on the way. Rimming off for Grant Jr. And I think he got a foul against the Tigers. Indeed. 2 Eagles on the floor. That's Drummond and Steers on the contact. The foul was assessed on Smith. That's his second. Lucian Brownlee's about to check into this game in between free throws, I believe, by Drummond. And what do you hear this crowd? Coach Brodnax is having a conversation with the official at the scorer's table, who's sorting out all of the changes now, going back and forth in this game. Hansen's back on for the Tigers. He's joined by Smith. Steers comes off. So it's Clayton, Marshall, Morgan, Brownlee at the line, and I believe Andrews Fulton is on the far block. He is. And the free throw, lift the rim and came out. Keep it 23-13. So Brownlee's going to have to wait. Harper's got it high right. Reverse it off head of the key. Now for Hansen, he turned it over. Marshall going strong with the left hand and a big finish. Give him 6. 25-13 Coppin. Get the windmill cranked up. Bouncing off in the lane. Harper runs it up, rim and good. Harper now with 6. 25-15 Coppin. And a timeout, Coppin State. 5:35 to go, opening half. It's now the Eagles 25, the Tigers 15. Back after a 60-second timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. 5:35 to go in the opening half. Coppins opened up a 10-point advantage once again on Savannah State, 25-15. Juwan Clayton with a game high of 9. Marshall off the bench, right behind him with 6. Harper for Savannah State with a team high of 6 points. Morgan on the inbound now for Clayton. Clayton, now to Brownlee. Now to the forecourt, and I mean he beat the 10 count by half a step. Andrews Fulton now ahead of the key. Back to Clayton. 10 to shoot. Clayton on the bounce. Penetration move. Swings it right corner to Morgan. Almost threw it out of bounds. Now to Andrews Fulton. And Chad with the reach-in foul, picking up his third.
Hey, Chad, Chad, let it go, Chad.
That brings Medley Bacon back to the scorer's table with 5:11 to go in the half. Harper now to Joseph, excuse me, Sellers on the far side, right? On the catch, Hanson head of the key. Near side left to Harper. Harper, left wing behind the arc. Bounce it down to the doorstep to Hanson. Kicks it back out to Harper for 3. It's on the way and good. Harper's first 3. That gives him 9 in the opening half. Makes it 25-18, Coppin. 4:45 to go. Clayton on a juggle. Now to the forecourt on the catch from Brownlee. Now between the rings, 12 to shoot. Marshall hands it off to Brownlee, left wing behind the arc with 8. 7, Clayton on the catch out of the key. Step right 3 is on the way, rim it off. Nobody home in a white jersey for the rebound. Over the top, Smith on the catch. Floats it up left of the lane, left it well short. Clayton on the run out, up the left side now for Marshall. Catches, goes strong, got undercut, no call. Tigers the other way very quickly. Out of the left corner, a 3 is on the way, rim it off. Out of the hand of Dotson. Battle for the rebound, and Brownlee trying to come away with it. Got tied up. And the arrow keeps it, I believe, with Savannah State. Grant Jr.'s back on. Exiting will be Dotson. Here comes Ibn Williams back in for Coppin State. Juwan Clayton checks out. Top side left on the catch. 3 ball for Hanson. Rim it off. Rebound to Morgan. Hands it off to Williams. Williams on the bounce. Now for Morgan up the left side. Morgan dumps it off left of the lane. Medley Bacon. Now to Williams. Runs it in the lane. Reverses back to Brownlee. Right corner Morgan. Step left 3 is on the way. Right of the rim. No good. Rebound to Hanson. Outlet now for Sellers. Sellers head of the key. Swings it near side left. Harper, baseline left. Reverse it out far side of the right to Smith. And he'll back it out with 17 to shoot. Refeeds it to Sellers. Sellers. Now for Hanson. Hanson with 9. Steps right with 8. Hanson off on a ball screen out of Grant Jr. with 5. Down to 4 to the right corner. A floater on the way across the rim. No, but a foul on the attempt by Smith. It's on Marshall, his first. It brings us to immediate timeout. 3:15 to go in the half. Coppin leads Savannah State 25-18 on the Coppin State Sports Network.
THB, Bagels and Deli in Charles Village, proud Coppin State basketball. Come enjoy Baltimore's hometown bagels, made fresh daily.
You're the one.
out of the timeout. Compton 1-for-8 from 3. And of the 32 field goal attempts by Savannah State, 24 of them are from 3. 3 of 24, 7-of-32 for the game. Compton 9-of-24, 1-of-8 as I mentioned from 3, 6-of-7 at the line. And a 10-rebound advantage of 26-16. An 11-4 deficit on the turnover margin. First free throw won't drop for Smith. They'll have another. Second one's good. Smith split a pair, 25-19. Compton by 6. Morgan to inbound. Gets it into Williams. Give it back to Brownlee. Brownlee now to Williams. Back to Brownlee. Into the forecourt. Lost the handle. Tried to get it back. Still fighting for the ball. Picked up by Joseph. He rolled over on the ball, and the arrow's going to give it back to Compton. Three minutes exactly remaining in the opening half. Williams on the bounce, far side left. Morgan, now to Brownlee, back to Morgan, head of the key. Back to Brownlee, step in, three up that left wing, good. Lucian Brownlee. 28-19, Compton. Hanson with it, head of the key. Steps right, got to the doorstep, glass, no, but a whistle and a foul as he got clocked out of bounds. Medley Bacon picks up the foul. That's his second. Hanson's got two free throws coming at the free throw line. Rattled the rim, and it's good. Hanson now with 4. 28-20, Compton State. Medley Bacon checks out. And Gear Ring checks in for the first time for Compton State. Second one, rim and off. Rebound to Marshall. Keep it 28-20, Compton, 2:20 to go. Brownlee, topside left. Now to Williams in the jump circle. Looking back, left at Brownlee. 15 to shoot. Marshall, high left out of Brownlee. Now to Williams, head of the key. Coming right of the screen from Ring. Top side left. Brownlee wants that three again. Rim halfway down. It popped out on him. Harper the other way. Now to the forecourt up the right side. Dribble penetration off the right of the lane for Grant Jr. Lob it back top side left to Sellers. 19 to shoot. Far side to the right. Now for Harper. Hanson off to the head of the key. Now for Hanson. Hanson wants a three. It's on the way. Rim glass, no good. Rebound, Marshall. Quickly to the forecourt. Now to Morgan. Left corner, Brownlee. Thought about a three. Steps right. Wants it again. Rim it off. Rebound poked away from Ring. And now the Tigers racing back the other way with 85 seconds to go in a half. Screeching to a halt as Sellers switches left to right and floats it up and scores. 28-22, Compton State. Brownlee's got it, far side. Now for Williams. Williams right of the jump circle. Williams now resets it with 13 to shoot. A minute to go in the half. Kick out left side. Marshall coming right. Got to the lane. Fights it up. Rim it. Rattled out.
Move the ball. Come on, yeah.
Rebound to Grant Jr. And up the right side, a carrying violation is assessed on Sellers. Drummond's back along with Clayton for Compton. Brownlee's coming off. So is Williams. Oslander's back to get Marshall. 48 seconds to go in the half. Drummond to Clayton. Back to Drummond. Near the time stripe. Reverse it back to Clayton. Now to the forecourt. Clayton head of the key, now for Auslander. Far side left. Goes to Morgan. Now to Clayton head of the key. Turns right. Reverse it off head of the key. Ring with it. 12 to shoot. Ring wants a three. Rim glass, no good. Rebound to Harper. Shot clock turned off, and Savannah State wants a timeout. 21.4 to go in the half. Coppin leads 28-22. We're back after a 30-second timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network.
30-second timeout, Savannah State.
Out of the Tigers timeout, 21.4 to go. Inbound in the forecourt. Harper at 6'7 will be the inbounder. Right in front of the Coppin bench. Inbound to Sellers. Sellers on the bounce along the sideline. Game clock down to 10, 9, 8, 7. Sellers on the bounce, runs it right of the lane, fights it up with the right hand, across the iron, no, rebound to Drummond. And he almost coughed it up underneath the opponent's basket. Long range three, hit the left of the rim and off. At the half, Coppin State leads Savannah State 28-22. And here at the break momentarily, we are joined by assistant coach Charles Agamagu for a brief moment.
Happy New Year, man. Happy New Year.
Indeed. And Charles, we talked about this before. Energy is a big key. Will Coppin build a 10-point lead off energy with a 17-0 run?
I tell you what, this is definitely a mucked up game. You know what I mean? And I think we built that lead because we played at our pace. Now, Savannah State, who won the conference last year, a title, they have a knack of making you play at their speed, and we can't do that. You know what I'm saying? We have to understand when we want to run and when we shouldn't run. We have to understand when they're trying to speed us up and when we're going at our own speed. So the 10-point lead happened because we played at our pace.
You mentioned the pace and also better shot selection. Even
Absolutely.
Though it's 2 of 12 from 3, you're
Absolutely.
Getting good looks at 3 as
Absolutely.
Opposed to volume 3s for Savannah State, 3 of 25.
But that's their game. You know, and again, it all goes back to not playing their game. The more we do what we do, it allows us to take the lead. You see what I'm saying?
So now I have to ask you this as a final question.
Okay.
Yourself, Coach Dixon, talk about this. It's defending at the other end of the floor
Absolutely.
In the second half.
Absolutely.
How do you do that?
I'll tell you one thing. Myself, Coach Dixon, Coach John, we didn't score 28 points. Our players did that. Myself, Coach Dixon, Coach John, we didn't hold Savannah State to 22 points. Our players did that. Just repeat it. They're more than good enough. They're more than capable. We did that at Notre Dame. We can do it again.
Appreciate the time.
Appreciate
the second
you,
half.
Thank
there
you.
It is. Happy New Year to my friend, Charles Agamagu. At the break, 28-22, Coppin in front of Savannah State. We're back on the radio side with the sounds of the first half. Back with more at the PEC here in the home of the Eagles, the Coppin State Sports Network.
Coppin State layup contest brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings, Owings Mills, Arundel Mills, and White Marsh. We have Denaya Chapman and Isaiah Hunley. And they have to get into a dressed in a Coppin State basketball uniform and make a layup. That simple. Dress in the uniform, make the layup. The winning contestant receives a $25 gift card courtesy of Buffalo Wild Wings. Contestants, are you ready? Get set. Go. All right, we got a winner. Congratulations. And the winner receives a $25 Buffalo Wild Wings gift card. When playoff football is on, you have to be a B-Dub for $5 game day deals. Buffalo Wild Wings, Arundel Mills, Owings Mills, and White Marsh Wings, Beer, Sports.
People ask me why I love Blazer Rewards so much. I mean, isn't it obvious? You earn points by hanging out with friends and eating wings and watching sports. And I mean all the sports, like football, baseball, basketball, soccer, karate, boxing, fencing. This one, I don't know, check it out. First, you join. Go to blazingrewards.com and follow the simple steps to sign up. Second, you earn. Just get off your butt and head to B-Dubs. Earn points by checking in, bringing friends, and ordering food. And finally, you redeem. Turn those hard-earned points into awesome rewards like wings, drinks, shareables, and more. Then just write your phone number on the check and rewards are deducted from your total. You can even earn points watching LARPing.
LARPing. LARPing.
Stay social with your favorite conference. Search MEAC Sports on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and on YouTube for day-to-day updates on everything MEAC. Also use the hashtags IBackTheMEAC and MEAC Nation to see your posts reposted. From the moment you enter the newly renovated Holiday Inn Baltimore Inner Harbor until you return home, you experience all the charm that give our hometown its Charm City moniker. Hotel is conveniently located 3 blocks from Baltimore Inner Harbor and also is across from the Baltimore Convention Center. Within 1 mile, guests can find the Horseshoe Casino, Hard Rock Cafe, and M&T Bank Stadium, home of the Baltimore Ravens. Holiday Inn, Baltimore, Inner Harbor. THB Bagels and Deli in Charles Village, proud sponsor of
Courtside once again at the PEC, and now joined by the athletic director, also known as my former partner on the broadcast, that would be Derek Carter. I don't know what I have to do to bring you back more than halftime.
Never consider it former. We're always connected. We can negotiate.
Speaking
always.
Of connected, DC, I got to ask you, 28-22 at the break, and it seems like the carryover over a great effort at Notre Dame, even though it was a 7-point loss against Mike Bray and the Fighting Irish, at their place, which having done a game or two at their place, that's an intimidating place to play. The guys were right there at the end.
No, they were. They were. And really, if you look at it, we gave it away down the stretch. This is all about knowing how to win and how to close out games because we were there and then, you know, turnovers and missed free throws and things of that nature. So hopefully it was a learning. You know, there are times when you can lose a game that truly can be a learning experience. And the team felt upbeat. Coach Dixon and his staff felt very upbeat after that as a nice bridge into conference play. So
early on, the Tigers got off the bus quickly, took an 11-4 lead. We talked about the process a year ago. How do you respond to adversity? How about 17-0 and up 10 at 21-11?
Well, absolutely. Absolutely. And it was the type of first half as we played against Notre Dame. Not really shooting the threes as much and getting higher percentage shots, which leads to a much more comfortable margin at the half. And it works out that way when you take better shots. So I like what I saw the first half.
So now let's break down both teams in the opening half and these numbers. Even though Coppins made 10 field goals, it's 2 of 12 from 3. But of the 12 looks, they were all quite fine. Conversely, Savannah State's 8 of 35. They come in the nation ranked in threes attempted, threes made. Well, they're 3 of 25 right now, DC.
Yeah. I mean, you're shooting 3 for 25. You know, now understanding who they are, that's kind of how they play.
Sure.
So you have to say the second half, perhaps they're going to shoot a better percentage than 3 for 25. But we continue to defend the way that we're defending. and play smart on the offensive end, and probably most importantly, eliminate the turnovers. We eliminate the turnovers, we're going to have a shot.
I have to have you take the hat off, if you will, for a moment as the broadcaster. Put that athletic director hat back on. What's next here at Coppin State for the programs?
Well, both programs, men's and women's, you know, that first, as we call those guarantee games, didn't turn out close to what we expected, particularly on the men's side. We scheduled, now, granted, our schedule, I believe, they say is ranked the second hardest in the nation. But we did sprinkle in some winnable games. And in hindsight, I feel this way. Coach Dixon and his staff feels that way. We let some games get away that we could have won. But that's over at this point. The only thing we can do now is learn. And as Coach Dixon says, the season's broken up into three components. Preseason, guarantee, in other words, conference, and then the tournament. So we're in phase two, and the key is to kind of erase the slate and say, here we are in conference play. Let's perform during conference.
And not to get too far ahead of ourselves, but on the 1920 calendar, you played so many games away from the PEC non-conference. Mm-hmm. Are you looking to change that as well to get some of those games?
Absolutely, absolutely. We have a couple of home and homes that will automatically come this way, but we're going to try to make it so our guys are not on the road for the entire or the majority of the preseason of the early, you know, pre-conference season. So you'll certainly see some adjustments in scheduling next year.
Because as we've talked about, for those that don't know, in the city of Baltimore and surrounding areas, this is the gem of the Charm City.
Sure.
It is.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah, and again, we're working on that. We're going to have more home contests, and the intention, as it was this year, frankly, the intention will be that we're going to come out of our pre-conference season with a much better record than we have now.
Well, growing up, and as you can see, I obviously stopped at some point on the growth chart. If you're going to do a game promotion, and I'd love to get with Ruffin and the guys on this one, can we do a Medley Bacon growth chart? I mean, can you imagine if you've got a 7-foot wall?
Hey, wall, did you say?
To put it up on. You're going to have to get the growth chart to go up on the wall.
That's okay. Hey, talk to Ruffin Bell and his staff, and we open to all ideas. Anything that can work. We want continuous support and to have this fan experience. So if a growth wall will assist us with that, hey, we're all for it.
Can you imagine taking the picture with him?
No. No. He's a tall young fella.
You can't do it on the wide shot. You got to go to this angle.
And look, he got a haircut. And he's still tall.
Oh, that's it's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Expectations the second half?
No turnovers. High percentage field goals. And play defense. And we'll be okay.
That's Derek Carter, everybody. Athletic director. And always welcome to the broadcast booth as a partner. And building it up big time here at Coppin State. Thank you, DC. Appreciate it.
Thank you, my friend.
Back after a timeout here on the Coppin State Sports Network. That court's out of the PEC. We're at the half, 28-22, Coppin with the lead over Savannah State. Here's a great look on the rip and run for Nigel Marshall. Bounce, lift off, and finish with the windmill jam. And that was in the midst of that 17-0 Coppin run to take the lead to 21-11. It's now 28-22 at the break individually for the Tigers. It is Grant and Joseph scoreless. Smith off the bench with two for the starters. Smith the free throw. Sellers with two. Dotson and Hansen each with four. Harper with nine. He's got one of the three threes for Savannah State. For Coppin off their bench. Ring, Medley Bacon, Auslander, along with Williams also a time didn't tally. Steers a two. Brownlee a three. Marshall with a bench high of six. For the starters, Morgan's been held scoreless. Cedric Council Jr. and Drummond each with two. Chad Andrews Fulton played in foul trouble. He's got three fouls and 4 points going to the second half. And DeJuan Clayton as a team high, tied for the game high, of nine. In 90 seconds, second half between Coppin and Savannah State comes your way next on the Coppin State Sports Network. Fresh 20 minutes go up on that game clock. 28-22, Coppin by 6 over Savannah State, getting set for the second half. Next up, Savannah State goes to Morgan State on Monday night. Next Saturday, they'll go on the road to Florida A&M. For Coppin, they're on the road at Dell State on Monday night. And next Saturday, they host Norfolk State as they will play in the midst of a back-to-back, if you will, Saturday, Monday, Norfolk State and South Carolina State here at the PEC. Steers, Drummond, Clayton, Morgan, and Chad Andrews Fulton for Coppin State to start the second half. Sellers and Dotson on that far side to inbound. Smith, Hansen, and down in the corner is Harper. And again, Coppin defending at the far end of the floor opposite their bench. On the bounce, Dotson picked it up. Give it up to Hansen. Hansen, a ball screen handoff down to Sellers. Sellers got cut off head of the key. 15 to shoot. Swings it high left. Back to Dotson. Dotson feeds it left to the lane. Now to Hansen. Takes it strong. Glass it good. 28-24. Coppin by four. 30 seconds into the second half. Pressure on the ball. Drummond has it come through the hands of the defender. Now into the hands of Morgan. Hands it off to Clayton. Clayton head of the key. Top side left out of Morgan. Back to Clayton head of the key. Clayton on the bounce. Bounce it far side of the lane. Now for Andrews Fulton. Chad out of the double team. Back to Morgan. Now to Clayton head of the key. Goes left of the lane. Kicks it out left corner. Drummond a high arc and three. Left of the rim, no good. Rebound Harper. Nearly lost the handle. Gave it up to Sellers. Sellers on the bounce, high right, turns left, got in the lane, lost the handle. They'll swing it near side to Hanson. Skip it back out top side left. And on the handle now, Dotson. Check that, Sellers with it. And came up empty. Andrews Fulton, the rebound, hands it off. Now for Clayton. Bouncing up the left side. Morgan, a catch and fire three on the way. Back of the rim, no good. Rebound to Harper. Runs it quickly into the forecourt. Hands it off to a trailing Dotson. Dotson gave it up head of the key. The three is on the way. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound to Clayton. Keeps the bounce alive into the forecourt and out of the jump circle. To the doorstep. Sears fights it up. Rim, no, but a whistle and a foul. Sears is fouled by Hanson. That's his second. Steers puts it on the way. Good. Steers now with three. Makes it a 29-24 Coppin advantage. Second attempt on the way. Rim it. Rattled out. Keep it 29-24 Coppin. Right corner kick to Smith. Going to the baseline. Nearly walked. Gave it up left of the lane to Hanson. To the rim and off. Bounced out to Dotson. Dotson runs it up strong. Left it short. Steers partially blocked it, and it's last touch by Coppin State out of bounds. Hey, 13 to shoot for the Tigers.
Now, Justin,
get it home.
Sellers for Dotson, and the three ball by Dotson is on the way and good. He's got seven. That's his second three. Coppin's margin is now 29-27. Andrews Fulton, high right. Coming to his left, hands it off to Drummond, runs it left of the lane, dumps it back door to Steers. Steers out of the corner, draws the double team, trying to step through it. Had the ball come free, he'll dribble toward the lane, and now swing it out to the top to Clayton, 10 to shoot. Right corner kick out, Steers wants a three, it's on the way, good. Justin Steers now with six. 32-27, Coppin, an answer three comes rimming off to the Tigers. Morgan on the catch on the run out. Power bounce to the lane. Gathers. Glass and good. All five starters now have scored. 34-27 Coppin State. 3 minutes into the second half. Harper on the bounce into the floor. They go. Drummond kept it alive. And then it's thrown around by Harper. Andrews Fulton goes over to help up to Quayne Drummond. He and Steers are coming off. Nigel Marshall is back. Well, actually, Tay's going to stay. Took quite the spill going for that loose ball. Drummond on the catch, draws the double team, swings it far side, now to Morgan. Morgan, penetration right of the lane, glass, rim, it spun off. Rebound to Harper. Into the forecourt now, Sellers. Hits a trailer, that's going to be Dotson for three, rim it off. Joseph, penetration, line to the lane, bounce it back door, running up strong with Sellers, missed it, and got it back and scored. 34-29, Coppin by five. 16-23 to go. Marshall on the catch. Draws the double team. Lob it back to Morgan. Now far side for Drummond. Right wing behind the arc to Clayton. 15 to shoot. Down to the doorstep to Andrews Fulton. Skip pass. High left to Morgan. Catch and fire. Three is on the way. Bang! Lamar Morgan from another zip code. Give him five. 37-29. Coppin. And answer three by Dotson. Give him 10. 37-32. Coppin by five. Pressure in the backcourt. Now for Morgan. Up the left side out of Marshall. Marshall left of the lane, into the lane. He's got Morgan left corner on a skip if he wants him. And then he dipped the shoulder going to the basket. Marshall called for the offensive foul. That's Nigel's second. It comes at 15:35 to go second half. Coppin State leads Savannah State 37-32. Back after this timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. Out of the timeout, 15:35 to go. Coppin State leads Savannah State 37-32. Grant Jr.'s back in. So's Collins Joseph. Joseph with the handle. Skip it to the corner. Dotson gave it up to a cutter. Rim good and a foul. Jalen Smith. 37-34 and a free throw coming. On the foul call. On Lamar Morgan, that's his first. Second on Coppin as a team in the second half. Comes at 15:23 to go. First free throw's on the way. Rim, it trickles off. Check that. The only free throw is on the way. Rim and off. Clayton into the forecourt. Right side to Morgan. Morgan, line, lane, fights it up, back of the rim. No, but a whistle and a foul. Smith with his third. So Lamar Morgan will step in, two free throws, with Medley Baking heading to the scorer's table. Romani Hansen also waiting. Hansen out of the U.S. Virgin Islands, hailing from St. Croix. Lamar knocks down that free throw, give him six all in the second half, makes it 38-34 Coppin. And a second free throw coming. On the way and good. Morgan now with seven, 39-34 Coppin. 15:10 to go. Joseph with it, top side to the right. On the bounce, end of the key, now to Hansen. Hansen looks left on the bounce. Ball screen, hand up, back to Sellers. Sellers right of the lane. Marshall came up limping. And the three out of the right corner is good for Joseph. 39-37, Coppin by two. Clayton to the forecourt. Left side, Morgan. Got the defender to fly by, launches the three and buries it. Morgan now with 10. 42-37, Coppin by 5. 14 and a half to go. Joseph with it high right. Reverse it off head of the key now to Hansen. Hansen. Ball screen handoff. Back to Joseph. Joseph wants another three. Glass rim it off. Rebound to Hansen. Trying to power it up on Medley Bacon. Got cut off on the far block. Head of the key to Sellers for three. Rim it off. Battle for the rebound. And I believe it's a foul on Coppin State. Nigel Marshall just picked up his third. He'll exit with three fouls and a limp. I think he got kneed in the thigh. It's either that or a hamstring. Because the way he came up limping is not good. Grant Jr. kicks it out right corner. Sellers on the bounce. Takes it right of the lane. Skip pass far side left. On the catch, Dotson ducks in, ran into Medley Bacon. And the only reason Medley Bacon's called for this foul is he kept his feet moving. That's his third. Rim and off by Dotson. Chad Andrews Fulton's going to replace Medley Bacon. Comes at 13:54 to go. 42-37 Coppin. And the second free throw comes off as well. Clayton with the handle. Line to the lane. Kick it out right corner. Steers thought about that three. Ducks under the defender. Fights one up anyway. Back of the rim, no good. Rebound Dotson. Sprints it back across the logo. And now topside right. Sellers on the catch. Bounce it down for Hanson with his back to the basket. Got into the lane. Kicks it back out. Dotson wants a three. Rim it off. Rebound Andrews Fulton. Poked away by Sellers. And out of bounds. Last touched by Savannah State. Williams replaces Drummond for Coppin. Harper's back to replace Grant Jr. Morgan to inbound. Gave it up to Williams. Now to Morgan. Feeds it back to Clayton. Clayton on the bounce. Now between the rings, coming left of the screen. Now for Andrews Fulton. Bounce it off to Steers, going strong. Count it, the foul. Steers went up to jam it home. He missed the dunk, but he had enough momentum on the ball to get it over the side of the rim and good. Harper picks up his second, make it 44-37, Coppin. Steers free throw on the way, good. Steers now with nine. 45-37, Coppin by eight. Closing in on 13 minutes to go. Joseph on the bounce, right of the lane. Bounce it back door, and a two-hand finish by Dotson, run of the baseline. Makes it 45-39. Clayton. Now for Williams, back to Clayton, head of the key. Clayton, high right now to Williams. Right corner, Morgan. Morgan, 13 to shoot. Back to Williams. Back to Morgan. Step left three is on the way. Rimming off. Andrews Fulton knocked it to the window. No good. Dotson, right side. Penetration by Joseph. And it's last touched by Coppin out of bounds. 23 to shoot for Savannah State. Harper to inbound from the sideline, looking, gets it in high right. Now for Sellers. Sellers between the rings, on the bounce, hands it back awkwardly to Harper, nearly lost the handle. Harper on the bounce, taking Steers to the rack, Steers with a block. Loose ball on the floor, picked up by Clayton. DeJuan on the march, now to the time stripe into the forecourt. Clayton goes right of the screen, line, lane, fights it up on the left and scores. Clayton with 11, 47-39, Coppin State. Lob at the rim, and it's good for Hanson. He's got eight. 47-41, Coppin, 11:39 to go. Across the time stripe, Clayton, near side left. Lamar Morgan a three, across the iron, no good. Steers an offensive rebound, turns left, try to fight it up. Nearly got fouled. Morgan, a corner three again. Good. Lamar Morgan. 50-41. Knocked free by Chad Andrews Fulton on the post-entry feed. Clayton, lob for Steers. Too tall and out of bounds. That brings us to a timeout on the floor. 11-12 to go. It's now Coppin State 50, Savannah State 41. Back after a timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. Out of the timeout, 11-12 to go. How about Steers with that finish? You just saw it live moments ago, and now replayed on CoppinStateSports.com. 11-12 to go. Coppin with a 9-point lead at 50-41 on Savannah State. Sellers on the bounce. Left of the jump circle, defended by Williams. Nearly lost it off his shoot top. Gave it up to Harper. Loose ball on the floor. Kick back out ahead of the key. Sellers wants a three. Rimming off. Rebound Drummond. Drummond in the corner. Now begins the march back across the time stripe into the forecourt. Now for Williams. And now Coppin starts to set up their offense in the forecourt. Right of the steer screen. Line, lane. Williams lost the handle out of bounds. So now on the march back, Sellers has it head of the key. Sellers on the bounce, swings it out to the right corner. Now for Smith, top side right, Sellers, 9 to shoot. Sellers, hesitation dribble, got in the lane, swings it back, top side left, 3 ball for Dotson, rim halfway down and out, rebound to Drummond. And a timeout Coppin State, just under 10 minutes to go. 9:59 to be exact. 50-41 Coppin leading Savannah State. Back after this 30-second timeout, make it a 60-second timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network.
To the Eagles, it'll go to a full timeout.
University means something different to everyone. Jason is a recent high school grad, attending Coppin full-time, getting his four-year degree, preparing for a lucrative career. Kimberly took time off to start a family and now attends Coppin part-time and enjoys the affordability and supportive environment. Kazim wants to change careers and finds that Coppin provides the flexibility he needs to keep working while getting that second degree. Coppin State University, something different to everyone, something special for you.
Out of the Coppin State timeout, they lead 50-41 with 9:59 to go. Morgan to inbound, gets it into Williams, back to Morgan, back to Williams, now between the rings. Ibben hands it off, now for Morgan, back to Ibben, 15 to shoot. Tay to the corner, now to Oslander, bounce it off, Medley Bacon at the free throw line, back to Williams, a trailing three, rim and off. Harper up the left side of the floor. They'll try a trailing three, rim and off, and now what? A whistle and a foul. The foul is on Oslander. That's his first. Fifth on Coppin as a team in the second half. Comes at 9:34 to go. Lob comes in. Dotson on the catch. Top side of the right. The three is on the way. Right of the rim, no good. Out of the hand of Smith. Battle for the loose ball. It's on the floor. They're going to tie it up. And the arrow brings it back to Coppin State. That's going to require a towel just outside the lane. On the bounce, it comes into Drummond. Drummond coming across the time stripe. Now to the forecourt. Swings it. Top side left out of Williams. Williams. Top side left. Left wing behind the arc. Swings it off now for Medley Bacon to the rack. Glass rim, no good. Here comes Smith the other way. Kicks it out. Far side left to Sellers. Spin move by Harper. Head of the key. Kicks it out near side of the right. Dotson. Down to the doorstep and in the lane. They'll kick it out to the far side left corner. Rimming off the three by Smith. Rebound to Morgan. Here comes Williams in traffic. Feeds it near side left. Drummond wants a three. It's on the way. Good. 53-41. Coppin now by 12. And an answer off the glass and good for Harper. Gives him 11. Makes it 53-43. Coppin by 10. At the 8:26 mark, and we're back after a 60-second timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. So out of the call timeout by Savannah State, Coppin leads 53-43 with 8:26 to go. Rebound margin to Coppin plus 7 at 42-35. Turnover margin 14-7. Coppin, they have got to clean that up. Even with a 10-point lead, rebound to turnover, it's even and nullified, plus and minus 7. Drummond to the forecourt, got bumped off by Romani Hansen. That's his third. Fourth team foul on the Tigers. Drummond on the inbound, the far sideline out of Clayton. Now for Steers. High left to Oslander. Backhand of the key now for Clayton. Clayton looking, kicks it out right corner now for Drummond. Drummond on the reversal for Steers. Last touch by the Tigers out of bounds. 10 to shoot.
10 on the clock. 10 on the clock.
Clayton with it high right. Step right three is on the way. Front of the rim, no good. And tracking down the rebound is Smith. Now to the forecourt. Feeds it off to Hanson, cutting in the lane. Glass rim, no. Wave everything off as that follow was dunked home and the foul. I believe they got Chad for his fourth. They did. It also brings us to a tie on the floor. 7:51 to go. It's now Coppin State 53, Savannah State 43. Back after this 60-second timeout, Coppin State Sports Network. Next home game, Norfolk State and Coppin State. Coming up next Saturday, 2 for the women, 4 for the guys. Moments ago, got a great look at the scoreboard on the men's side. Dell State with an early 3-2 lead at Norfolk State. Now, you see the fan right there with the Ravens pullover. Let's go Ravens in the playoffs. Last time I looked, the Colts were shutting out the Texans 21-0. That was at the break on Wild Card Weekend. Now it's early third, same score, 21-0. Here it's 53-43, Coppin leading Savannah State. Hanson at the free throw line, puts it on the way, good. Makes it 53-44, Coppin. Second one's good. Hanson's in double figures, give him 10. 53-45, Coppin. 7:45 to go. Again, pressure by the Tigers. Clayton handles it nicely with Drummond in the backcourt. Now Clayton to the forecourt. Ring checked in out of the timeout. He'll swing it right corner. Drummond wants that three. It's on the way. Right of the rim, no good. Rebound Dotson. Bounce it off. Joseph, head of the key. Joseph with it, now bouncing off to Hanson. Hanson, now back near side of the right, gave it up to Smith. Smith on a ball screen handoff. Gave it up to Joseph. Joseph, a step right three is on the way, rim no, and a whistle, and I believe a foul on DeJuan Clayton on the three attempt. That's his first. Collins Joseph. Also out of the U.S. Virgin Islands, St. Thomas. He gets the first two. That gives him five, makes it 53-47, Coppin State. Morgan replaces Oslander in the Coppin State lineup. Critical time of the game now, closing in on 7 minutes to go and a six-point lead. Third one's also good. So Joseph got all three, give him six in the game. Hanson checks out. Harper's back. 53-48, Coppin by five. This is now seven unanswered by Savannah State after Coppin had a 12-point lead at 53-41. Drummond back to Clayton. Clayton on the bounce. Steps left behind the arc. Now reverse it off. Ring's got it. Put it behind his back. Line, lane. Shovels it back door. Steers with it. Pivots out of the lane. Now for Clayton. Head of the key with spin to shoot. Duan Clayton. Glass and good. 55-48. Coppin by seven. Right side three is on the way. That's good for Smith. Give him seven. And now Savannah State trails by four, 55-51. Morgan lost the handle. Shovels it left corner to Ring. Ball screen hand up back to Clayton. Left corner Morgan. Try to go baseline left. Got cut off. Back to Drummond. Now to Clayton. 10 to shoot. Clayton left in a lane. Ducks into traffic. Count it and a foul. Coach Brian Ness is asking the official. That was on the floor. Clayton with 15. 57-51. Chad Andrews Fulton replaces Gear Ring in the Coppin lineup. Sellers assess the foul. It's his first. Clayton at the free throw line, trying to complete the three-point play. Comes rimming off. 57-51 Coppin, 6 minutes to go. Top side right, Joseph. On the ball screen, handoff, it got jarred loose. Bounce ahead to Morgan. Goes strong with the right hand and scores. Lamar with 15. 59-51, Coppin by eight. A little bit of a mini run here at 4-0. Sellers on the bounce, high left. Hands it off between the rings. Spin move by Harper. Nearly lost the handle. Kicks it out left side. A three is on the way. Rimming off out of the hand of Smith. Rebound, Coppin State. Steers wants the ball up here on the left side. Nobody home. Oh, my. It's knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Tigers and Joseph. Steers may have snapped the rim off if he would have received the basketball. Morgan on the inbound now for Clayton. Clayton between the rings. Trying to step left. Now reverse it off right side to Morgan. Bouncing off to Steers. Turning left. Blocked out of midair by Hanson. Sellers on the run back, and we got a whistle and a foul. It's on Steers. That's his first. Nigel Marshall heads back to the scorer's table. Free throw by Sellers is good. Give him five, make it 59-52, Coppin. Second Sellers free throw is good. 59-53, Coppin State. Bounce comes into Drummond. Drummond now for Clayton. Gave it up to Nigel Marshall. He's fouled trying to split the double team. Joseph with his second. Sixth on Savannah State. That's a non-shooting foul with 4:49 to go. Shot clock stands at 20. Bounce comes into Clayton. Top side of the right. Now comes to his left. Bounce it off weak side left and out of bounds. intended for Lamar Morgan. Pounded his chest saying his fault, he didn't catch it. Smith checks in, Hanson will check out. 4:41 to go, Coppin by 6 at 59-53. Sellers on the bounce. Now between the rings, dribbles it far side left. Great look at it from our corner camera. CoppinStateSports.com. Reverse it off, high left. Now penetration left of the lane, high off the window and good. For Terrell Harper, he's got 13. 59-55, Coppin. 4:10 to go. Drummond into the forecourt. Now for Clayton, top side left. Left of the lane, fights it up, and destroyed going to the rack. It's either Harper or Smith with the foul. It's on Smith. That's his fourth. It brings us to a timeout on the floor. 3:59 to go. Coppin leads Savannah State 59-55. Back after this timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. All I want to know is from the fan you just saw on CoppinStateSports.com, was he dancing to the music on the sound system or from the iPod or iPhone that he had with the earbuds in? That's all I want to know. We may never know. 59-55, Coppin leading Savannah State. Rebound margin for Coppin State was once, I think, like 20-8. It's now 43-39. Clayton at the free throw line knocks it down. He's got 16. Again, 15-8 turnover margin. Coppin. Clayton, second free throw, rim it off. 60-55, Eagles. Picked off by Drummond. Throws it center of the floor to Clayton. DeJuan going strong to the rack and scores with the right hand. Clayton with 18. 62-55, Coppin. 3:45 to go. Sellers with the rock. Swings it high right now to Joseph. Joseph on the bounce, right corner. Three ball on the way. Rim it off for Dotson. Battle for the rebound. Pulled down by Harper in the corner. Give it back to Dotson. Coming across the lane. Swings it far side left. Another three is on the way. Good again. Harper now with 16. 62-58, Coppin by four. And Savannah State burns a 30-second timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. Out of the Tigers' timeout. Coppin with a 62-58 advantage. And the ball with 3:22 to go. Coppin's got two timeouts left. Savannah State's got one. All the media timeouts have been expunged. Clayton. Bounce it back for Drummond in the backcourt. deflected away from Morgan and stolen. Head of the key, Joseph wants a three, rimming off, rebound to Morgan, into traffic, he got fouled. Hanson, I believe, picks up his fourth. Harper with his third, pardon me. Each team now with eight personals in the second half. Morgan in a one-and bonus. He and Hanson exchanging Facebook identities and Instagram after the little extracurricular, after the foul was called at the other end of the floor. Rimming off the free throw. Ring had it and lost it. So now Sellers the ball down by four, 62-58, closing in on three to go. Harper on the kick out, high right, and Joseph traveled. Tried to go right to left, coming back to the head of the key. Morgan on the inbound, looks for Clayton. Lobs it to him in the lane. In the backcourt. Now at the time stripe, is greeted by the double team. Stops in the jump circle. Now finds Andrews Fulton, head of the key. And he's reached upon and fouled by Hanson. That's his fourth.
Hey, free throw, fellas!
Yeah, it's been less than chippy, if you will, between these two teams. And the MEAC opener for both. First free throw, rim, glass, and good. Chad's got five, makes it 63-58, Coppin. Second attempt on the way, good again. Andrews Fulton now with six. The lead is six. 64-58, Coppin, closing in on 2:45 to go. Sellers with it high right. Hands it back. Hanson wants a three. Rim it off. Rebound to the corner. Sellers. Sellers now backs it out. Now explodes right of the lane. Floats it up. Glass and good. Sellers now with eight. 64-60. Coppin. 2:25 to go. Again, the 2-2-1 trap. Drummond over the top. Picked off. And Andrews Fulton bumps off the Tigers player going for the ball, and he'll foul out with 2:20 to go. He tried to pick it off from Dotson. And now Evan Williams coming to the scores table. So now Dotson with time stopped at 2:20 can cut into the Coppin lead 64-60. First one's on the way, and it's good. Dotson's got 13, 64-61, Coppin. Ring checks out. Second one's on the way, good. Dotson now with 14, 64-62, Coppin State, 2:20 to go. Inbound to Clayton. Bounce it out of the double team. Now for Williams. Williams, bounce it off right side out of Morgan. Morgan now for Williams. Back to Clayton. Clayton left of the jump circle. Clayton lost the handle. Was it knocked free? And they say Joseph last to touch it with 14 to shoot. 2:04 to go. Inbound to Clayton. DeJuan head of the key. Takes it right elbow, swings it left side. Drummond floats it up from 10, missed everything. Hit the underside of the window, and Medley Bacon had a pinball off a player out of bounds. Last touch by Dotson. Two to shoot. And Coppin's going to take a timeout with 1:51 to go and 2 seconds on the shot clock. Back after a 30-second timeout on the Coppin State Sports Network. So out of the reset, 151 to go. Coffin by two at 64-62. 2 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Drummond, I believe, is going to inbound from the baseline. He's defended by Hanson. Drummond looking. Bounce it into Steers, and it's going to be an offensive foul against Coppin State. On the far side of the floor, Medley Bacon with his fourth. It comes at 151. Savannah State with a two can tie, a three for the lead. It would be their first lead since 11-10. If. Sellers. Now to the forecourt, high left. Reversing field, got a three away, rim and off. Tip follow is good. For Dotson, he's got 16, and we're tied at 64. 95 seconds to go. Clayton up the right side now for Drummond. Drummond up the right side, looking for a screen. And now gives it up to Morgan, high left. Feeds it down the block. Medley Bacon going to work in the lane. Right-hand hook, last and good. His first field goal puts Coppin on top, 66-64. 70 seconds to go. Sellers with the handle, head of the key. Uses the screen, goes left in the lane, reverse it off. Harper, a three for the lead. Back of the rim, no good. Rebound, Clayton. Under a minute to go. Coppin leads 66-64. Clayton with the handle, now to the forecourt. Each team with a timeout remaining. Medley Bacon sets the screen. Clayton along the sideline, and we got a whistle and what? A foul call on Sellers. That's his second. Both teams now over the limit. It is double bonus situation for Jawan Clayton at the free throw line. Rim and off on the free throw attempt. He splits a pair. He'll force Savannah State into a three to tie. And he does. He split a pair. 19 for Dewan Clayton. 67-64 Coppin. Left to right comes Sellers. About a 10-second game and shot clock differential. Sellers on the bounce, high left. Harper thought about a three, swings it right side. Joseph wants a three, rimming off, and a whistle and a foul. Joseph, who has already hit three free throws. And Lamar Morgan picks up his second of the process. Joseph again steps into the free throw line. A chance to tie with three free throw makes at 26.4 to go. First of three, rimmed out. Second one's on the way, rimming off. That one hit the back iron. Third attempt by Collins Joseph. On the way, good. He went one of three, give him 7-67-65 Coppin. Inbound to Drummond, shot clock turned off, 23 seconds and counting. Clayton on the run, into the forecourt. Goes across the head of the key, picks up the bounce, looking for an outlet now for Morgan, and he got fouled. Foul is on Joseph, that's his third. 16.4 to go. These are huge free throws for DeJuan Clayton. First one's good. DeJuan's got 20. 68-65. Coppin by three. And the second one's good. 21 for Clayton. 69-65 Coppin. Head of the key. Harper's got it. Turned it over on a travel or a foul. Oh, my. That's a foul call on Steers. His second. Harper at the line, two free throws, not three. 11.4 to go, Coppin by four. First one, rim glass good.
Justin and Brendan.
Harper now with 17, makes it 69-66, Coppin State.
Do I got a timeout?
Second one on the way, good. Harper now with 18, 69-67, Coppin. 11.4 to go. Steers and Medley Bacon check out. Oslander and Williams check in. Inbounder will be Lamar Morgan. Inbound comes to Clayton. He's immediately fouled by Joseph. That's his fourth. It comes at 10.3 to go. Steers and Medley Bacon check back in. And now Steers and Medley Bacon will head back to the bench with 10.3 to go. Clayton all by his lonesome for Coppin State at the free throw line. He's got four Tigers on the blocks. Clayton knocks down another huge free throw. Give him 22. 70-67, Coppin. Second one's on the way. Good again. Clayton now with 23. 71-67, Coppin. Quick fire three off the right side. Rimming off out of the hand of Joseph, and it is last touched, I believe, by Coppin State on that rebound. And Hansen, I believe, is going to pick up the foul and foul out. He does. 4 seconds to go. Hansen will exit with 10 points. And now it's Quayne Drummond will step into the free throw line, trying to put some icing on a would-be Coppin cake. He's got to hit at least one. It's a four-point margin, and the way the Tigers shoot the three with a three and an and one, that would tie us the way we stand right now. Free throw's good. Thank you, Drummond, for making it now academic. 72-67. Coppin on the verge. Second one's on the way. Rim glass good. Drummond now with seven. 73-67 Coppin. Right side rim glass. No, out of the hand of Smith, and that'll do it. Coppin State ends the streak. And they booked their first win of the 18-19 campaign with a 73-67 win over Savannah State in open MEAC play at 1-0. Behind a fine effort by DeJuan Clayton, who finishes with a game high of 23. So we'll step out for a moment as they perform the alma mater comeback. with our postgame show after this on the Cava State Sports Network. Joined courtside now by head coach Juan Dixon. And coach, coming down the stretch in about the final 2.5, 3 minutes, four times Savannah State got within two, and your guys had an answer.
Last year against Savannah State, we was in the same position. And they pressed us. We wasn't as disciplined. But I know our guys, the last four practices has been at a high level. Offensively, defensively, we played extremely well against Notre Dame, so we were extremely confident coming into this game. But Savannah State, they're a scrappy team. They play extremely free, take any shot that they think is a good shot, and it's hard to play against a team like that. But I'm proud of our guys. I love our guys, and we're just going to keep playing with confidence.
You have a young man 7 feet tall in Mr. Medley Bacon, and he picked a fine time for his only field goal of the night.
Yep. I mean, yesterday I got with Brendan personally, and we worked on that exact same move. And I don't know if you saw, I ran down the sideline, and I said, jump hook, big fella, and he went to it. And, you know, those type of moments allow a young freshman to grow. Like, he's a seven-footer that can move, all right, that plays extremely well defensively, understand our principles defensively. If he can be confident in his ability to just get to his floater, crab dribble, get to his jump hook, he's going to really help us moving forward.
We've talked about it time in, time out over the last 2 years about finishing down the stretch and defending at the other end in the second half, and it seemed like the guys did that.
Yeah, we did. I mean, we got to get Justin Stairs, Nigel Marshall, our freshman, to guard better. But as a team, I thought we did a terrific job. We held them to 30% shooting. They took 50 threes, right? It's hard to compete against a team like that, but You know, our guys have fun today, and they play hard-nosed defense.
A lot of confidence, even though it was a loss to Notre Dame. Big win to open the conference schedule. And now, finally, Coach, you're going to Delaware State on Monday night. What's your expectation?
We got to try to find a way to get Cedric Council healthy first, get our guys rest up, get some recovery done, and we're going to watch film tomorrow, have a walkthrough, and get ready Monday.
Appreciate the time as always. Congratulations on the MEAC opening win.
Yep.
There it is. Head coach Juan Dixon after a 73-67 win here at the PEC. Game high to DeJuan Clayton with 23. And Lamar Morgan finishes as well with 15. And DeJuan is our Buffalo Wild Wings player of the game. Let's do this for Mr. Clayton. And I got to ask you, last year you battled through that injury. You sit out most of the year. What's this like to come back now and play on a day-in, day-out basis?
It's great. It's just a blessing for me, missing the whole season. No player ever wants to go through that, so I just want to come out here and give it all I got.
Coming down the stretch, as I asked Coach, four times in the last 2 minutes, Savannah State got it within two. As a primary ball handler, what's going through your mind?
We got to make winning plays. I try to keep the ball in my hands as much as possible to make good decisions and lead my team to a win.
How big are those free throws? 5 out of 6 down the stretch.
Very big.
What do you expect from Delaware State on Monday night as well?
We expect them to play hard, just like every other MEAC team. We're going to play hard as well.
Appreciate the time. Congratulations on the MEAC opening win.
Thank you.
There it is. DeJuan Clayton, our Buffalo Wild Wings player of the game here at the PEC. It's going to do it. MEAC opener goes to Coppin, 73-67. Thank you so much for watching and listening on the Coppin State Sports Network.